We'll find out what the weather's like out there. We got about 10 minutes in either direction to get out in this little Bell Ranger here. And we're shooting with a Tyler side mount. Mickey's going to be hanging out the side of the chopper as we get some of the wide ocean establishing shots of the boat, some close-ups of the boat after the storm, and other transitional footage that'll allow me to put music under this and pace out the story a little bit. So I got a list actually of things that I need, and then we're going to go for beauty shots and sunsets and whatever we can come up with. Sails going up, preparing for the storm. After the storm, huddled by the wheel, the two kids and the captain. Sunset with the captain only in full sails, and then one with no one on deck while we believe that they are down below learning how to do the sailor's hornpipe. So it's like the first time I've been in a chopper since Dom. I'm wearing my boonie hat. I'm big excited about this, and I believe at this point that I am not too fat to go up in the chopper. I think they will be able to download some fuel, which is kind of wild, you know. And other than that, we are on day
eight?
Seven.
Eight.
Started on Monday. Today's Monday.
Seven.
That'd have to be seven.
Come in, Mickey Freeman.
Something like that. Yeah. Today is day seven. So we've got five more days after this. A couple more days here at the school, and then at the Wapama where we're doing the interiors.
Oh, no.
So that's going to be loads of fun. My actors and actresses are doing so well. I am so proud of them. I really am. Bob Parnell, who we chose for the captain, is giving me first-rate performances all the way through. And the kids, who were a little bit overwhelmed by the storm when we were shooting the special effects sequences, have really turned into a couple of responsive professionals. I'm heartened by it.
What was the funniest thing that happened so far?
Funniest thing that happened for me was when I stood in for a line for the captain while he was over in makeup. I was supposed to just run the kids through part of the storm sequence, and rather than just let me do the line, the crew decided to turn on all of the special effects. I was hit with about 1,500 gallons of water and a wave, and had fog blowing in my face while I was reading the lines. It'd be cool. I just finished it out. I wound up getting drenched to the bone, and the resultant cough and sore throat will probably develop into walking pneumonia.
Which
I'm waiting to get going too. Mark's Mark yelling. Mark, if you see him anywhere in this tape, you'll know it's Mark, because he always looks like he's having a gastritis attack. He's in charge of bringing us in on budget. And if he laughs, that means that something's dreadfully wrong, and he's just slipped into a protective laughter to keep him from cracking up.
And he's attached to his phone.
Yeah, he is attached to his phone. He has a personal phone bill of $1,200 a month that he's just done for this production. So in a few minutes, we're going to take off in that little bird over there, and I'm going to be on a video monitor watching what Mickey's shooting on 35. And I guess that's about...
What's the worst thing that happened?
The worst thing that happened was hiring you to do this goddamn tape. Every time I stop, you ask me questions and everything. You know, this is taking me out of my creative self. See, a moment ago, I was in my creative flux, and I was able... You know, I'm an artist. So, like, I throw up before I create. I have to. My entire system goes. And every time you bring this camera on me, I'm forced to talk. So, Actually, the worst thing that happened so far was finding out this morning that out of four scenes that we shot yesterday, four takes of one scene, two of them were destroyed in the laboratory last night when the machine went amok. And one of them was really a no. One of the two that made it through is not a good take, and the other one will do if I work on it a little bit. So rather than having a lot of choices on that one scene going into editing, I'm going to be kind of restricted. I'm really looking forward to editing it because I think I've got everything I need, and some of the shots, like the one we did today in the program director's office, are real beautiful stuff. Really beautiful. So kids, remember, tell your mom if it's not Argenté, the videotape, you're not happy. So go out and buy this videotape.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, but he obviously must have lost battery power on his phone. You're just using it 2 minutes. So let's get him a new battery, okay?
Our director.
Easier said than done, my friend. Don't know where he is. We're spread out all over the hell.
The hell is just a wonderful place to be. Yeah, whenever you see him, if you see him, fine. Thank you.
Did you hear what he just said about you, Mark?
What?
He said you look like you're having a gastritis attack all the time.
Who?
Martin.
Hey, do you happen to have our still photographer over his camera?
You said you have the biggest phone bill.
Still
he went on. That
sounds great. Get a shot of me.
You're going to be here, right?
Yes.
Okay, I got the battery block tied down.
Uh-huh. I don't think it would be right if I went up into the air without a Milky Way tucked into my boonie hat. It's sort of the new heavyweight Vietnam veteran, a la come filmmaker.
Yeah, I got the you want some bubble gum for the hat too there?
So, I got some regular gum. If I want to stick stuff up on there, I'll do it as I go here. Well, I'll just make sure I got my keys before I get in. You know it's really wild? I don't have my keys.
What do you need your keys for? The keys to the limo?
The keys to my car. Yeah. Nice. Ah, here we go. We should, John here?
No. We need to start moving this equipment back.
Mike,
can you help Mitch move this equipment here? Just back to this area.
Okay, don't tape it down. I'll work with it out there.
But I'll give you a piece of tape on it.
Well, they're going to, yeah, right.
Where are we going? Guys, you're moving stuff.
We have to move it.
Operate it easier, right?
Denise?
Yeah.
Oh, where does Martin go? Oh, I just want to see where he's going to sit. It's in the front?
Water.
Huh. I suppose they got a 90 degree
power cord. This is going to be fun. It's dramatic.
Yeah. It's going to be fun. Plus, we're going to get some great footage. I think every movie should have a car chase scene, a love scene, and a chopper scene.
Hello.
We don't have a love scene and we don't have the car chase, so.
Hi, Kay.
Yeah, you boys
I'm banking on this.
Yeah, that's good.
Hey, Marty,
step up for me.
Do you want to sit inside and we can
get the ledge case.
Sure. Table out more.
10-1.
Will, can I enter?
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm sorry?
No, it's not.
Sure. You get hot.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'll make sure that the.
I got no problem with that. Okay. So when will I see you? About 7 to 8, 8:30, something like that. Okay.
Hi, Judy.
All right, let me just do this.
Okay.
Hey?
Yeah.
These came from LA?
Promise?
Yeah, the 138s? Oh, okay.
Cool.
All right. Some settling may occur.
So Lee Baby is still in good with you, man?
No.
He's old.
Yes.
Okay. I need my,
Take the brace off?
Yeah. Is my green jacket and gray bag down, Mark?
Yeah, I can get those down.
I need to get that right.
Right.
Okay, let me hang on.
What is going on?
For Rito to clear out, then I'm going to undo the lock.
Yeah, that's okay, sir.
Yeah, we're still on.
I'm going to pull a rivet off of here.
Okay. We got enough wire there?
Yeah, you know what I'd like to do is I'd rather leave the bundle in the back.
Okay.
Which hat city do you think of? This one? I think this would work.
Do you have a hat now?
Yeah.
Yes. I'll just let you look at that and I'll run it for the
stand.
Okay. Should we test it?
Got it. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks,
man.
Thank you. Yes.
Okay.
You read me? I gotta press this, huh?
Yeah, what you do to send is press this button right here.
You read me now?
Yeah.
Am Mike Maley's got lots of experience in this. He's had about 200 aerial flights, but he's chosen to take the portico instead of the aerial shot.
I don't believe this. This is your first
time. I don't mind doing this.
One more on the tailway. Are you going to want to
Did you hear him?
Tape this down. Or do?
It's a lot fun when they do the
cold ones. Cold ones.
Where did you find them gooey boots there, Mickey?
I had these with snow for years, and also aerials. Yeah. I mean, they just keep you, you know.
Tom, seen a picture?
Stuck. You know what it's like doing aerials, don't you?
No.
Yeah.
I'll turn this off. Got it.
I hear you sniveling enough back there.
You got the gaffer's tape back there, Tom?
Are we hot here?
Yeah, you don't have your camera on.
Oh, there should be.
Can't see Mickey then.
Burst?
Yes, burst.
It's a simulation. It's a simu play.
Can we come forward a little on this?
Sure can.
I'm going to take that with me.
Okay.
That orange coat. As much as you can. There. That's better. Okay, hold it.
Will? Yeah. Where should Mickey's bags go? What do you want?
Right behind me.
Yeah, there. Behind you?
Right in there. Other door. Is your zoom speed, is that set okay for you?
Yeah, we can change that for you.
Let's go a little, let's slow it down. The pull out.
On the zoom?
Yeah.
It's quite a piece of equipment.
There's no zoom. Okay.
Zoom is zoom.
Fine. Zoom, golly, golly.
Did you go to that camp too?
I did. Camp Saratoga. Did we date there?
I think so.
Okay.
No gaffer's tape back there.
A piece of yellow here for you. If you get an orientation symbol that you like, you can take it down.
Same part. Okay, so that's just stuck to the barrel.
That's just there. That's just standing by.
Hey, Rita. One. Is that the tape of the 2-inch roll of gaffer's tape around?
Right here. Down
the
other.
This is the repeater.
Okay, so there's a 2-pro mist.
2
and
mist.
Pola.
What's 1A.
So.
Thanks.
Tom,
hold on.
You want a tape for that?
Yeah, let's have a little piece of tape for that aperture. Just put it down at 8.5 there.
Who's sick?
Okay. Tom, how's this table going to do, man?
Okay.
We're close. We're very
close.
You ready, Will?
I'm ready.
Good. Can we go, guys?
Hang on a second. Let me put my jacket on.
They all got sick?
Mike, stand by that thing. Get ready to grab it or do something.
Where's Rita?
Right here.
Can we get some slack on this one cable right here?
Yeah.
Cool. Alright, Tom, take this one.
What? Be on deck.
Huh? Marty, you got room in your feet?
That's good.
Plenty of room. That good?
Yeah.
Drinks.
You know what? I'd rather not have those
snow
here.
Alright. Well, you want anything to drink right now?
We have ice water.
We were talking about.
No, we're going to be back in 45 minutes, so.
Michael, is that Mike Wilson coming over your headset?
You fly in it?
I was talking to you from
right,
the boat.
Right, good.
I wish I was.
Uh-huh. You wish you was?
Couldn't have been someone on the boat.
I'm running. Away.
Who were we just talking to?
Who are you talking to?
Thank you.
Yeah. I did not hear. That was Mike Wilson saying they're sick. Yeah. Right?
Yeah, you might be able to hear.
Who was talking to who?
Danny?
I don't know.
Oh, that was Bob. Maybe that was Bob Mooney.
Who was talking to me just now about the kids being sick?
Dave who?
I heard Dave Childers. I'm not sure who he spoke to.
Now,
no, Annie, we just got a phone call.
No,
yeah, the fog's rolling in. Big deal. Anyway, we got a phone call from somebody at the boat. And they said the kids were sick and the wizard was sick too.
It's a gyro mounted.
Also at stage.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, we ready?
Good, John Baker.
I'm
right here, buddy.
Calling in from the boat.
Mike. Copy.
Lock in. I don't want to say nothing.
We can
why are you guys dressed with jackets on?
Yeah.
What? It's going to be cold up there?
No.
Now you should be on your other radio or somebody.
Well, dress up with jackets.
Michael, when they take off,
do you want to do this thing?
Sure.
Oh, that's true.
I mean, I've had my whole body in shock before.
Is that right?
From being so cold in a helicopter.
Okay, let's go.
Let's do it.
All right.
Have fun. Take care. Get the shot.
Got speed.
My tail's going to come back around this way, so everybody's going to want to move off. And we're
a few minutes. Have we done a radio check here? Radio check.
And that one bungee, the black one.
Okay. Oh, okay. So is somebody helping me?
Martin, can you hear me?
Okay, good.
So everybody's even good about it.
Do you hear me now?
What did they have for lunch?
I hear
lunch. Big mistake. Big mistake.
What did they have for lunch?
I couldn't find any other bungee.
Hey, Mark, this is a constant speed motor, right?
Check back.
Double check. They'll be up over you. It's a white and red helicopter. You'll see the camera hanging on the side. Okay.
We got
we put on 32.
Mickey. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You won't be able to hear Marty until they power up the helicopter.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you hear? Does Mickey hear you?
Marty.
Do you hear me?
When he fires up the helicopter.
Have you found it yet?
The gray one on top of it.
Yeah, it's all underneath here.
You want to be able to talk,
Frank?
To
I will be right there.
Sorry.
Okay.
Now, you won't be able to talk to anybody if you want. You want
I just, I had, all I have to do is.
So you can reach in. There's
not a
law.
Over there, guys.
Okay. Heads up, Paul.
Oh, they need one?
There.
Just grab one.
We're doing it.
Freeman, the famous BG.
He's tough.
in from the first pass out of the boat in the chopper, and it took us about 10, 12 minutes to get out there and back, and we spent about 10 minutes out there. Everybody on the ship boat is sick. There were about 18 people puking out there. In fact, the captain and the two kids at the wheel, one of the kids was puking while we were filming. So it's going to be a very interesting shot to see what we get. It's beautiful, but it's not a problem.
You know what?
Record the next time you go up.
Yeah. So right. They're in distress out there.
Here, I'll
we better go, huh? Yeah, we gotta go, like, immediately.
So, can't put the kids...
Who's out there that's so sick?
Everybody. When somebody starts puking, it's like a chain reaction. One person throws up, the smell, the look of it makes other people puke. Everybody's puking on the boat.
The wizard? Your wizard?
The wizard is puking in his beard right now.
So let's get some beauty shots in the boat.
Where they were. They were about a mile past the Golden Gate. And there were swells, big swells out there. The boat was hopping.
No. The fog coming in?
Yeah. Well, we're now the fog so is much, the loose cable was coming back so far we couldn't even get close.
Really?
Yeah, do you see that cable on that back mast? Yeah. Whatever, the back boat
shot. Yeah. Really? Yeah, it's pretty rough.
Really? So you couldn't get close to the boat because of the cable?
Mm. Yeah, well, we got close.
We still got close.
But not as close as we could have if it's smooth.
Yeah, and we gotta make a run out there because these people are gonna give up.
You want me over there?
Okay, so I'm gonna take this back. You don't need this anymore, right?
Right. Thank you.
Okay.
People need to get up there now.
That's what I'm saying. So
I'm sure they are.
But on the way back, what I'm suggesting.
You're not going back up?
Yeah, we're gonna go back up after we refuels, put in about 20 gallons. And we're taking another 400-foot magazine with us, so once we shoot that first 400, which is 10 minutes, we might be able to drop in. We probably won't be able to drop anywhere because it's all Golden Gate National Park. So what we'll do is probably get a lot of altitude and get up where it's calm, above the water, and try to change it midair. I think he's going to change it midair.
Change it midair.
He's done this before, right? Helicopter stuff.
What, maybe?
Yeah. good goodbye.
I'll never get this.
It happened 25 minutes ago at about 6:35.
Mark, I'm getting transferred to the Coast Guard right here.
Okay. Somebody call them.
He's got it.
They'll have the information on what hospital they're taking him to. Now, where did it happen? At Mile Rock?
Okay, you need some backup? You need a backup? Or?
No, we're set. We're going up from Rendon.
Okay. All right, we'll meet y'all there to get the information. Hey, can you move your van?
No, come back here. It's too. This is my eagle eye.
Get the stuff. Hey guys, let's carry this. Move it out of here. Come on, Tilt.
I want some shoes.
You're watching Channel 7 News. Now, Channel 7 News at 11.
Good evening, I'm Ana Chavez.
And I'm Lisa Stark.
Narrowly averted tonight, just outside the San Francisco Bay, a helicopter circling more than 70 feet above the ocean crash-landed. The pilot and two passengers were all rescued from cold, choppy waters near Fort Baker. The helicopter, owned by the Astrocopter Company, was being used by a film production company to get aerial shots of a sailboat. A co-worker who slept with the accident victims in the hospital described what happened.
Evidently, they were just finishing a shot where they were going across the boat and up high, and then they were going to swirl back down. As they came up high on one of those passes, they lost power. And Raymond, the director of photography, said, "Are we all right?" And the pilot said, "No, not all right." And that spun all the way down. He managed to have it land on both the runners. And before they could get out, the helicopter pitched over and sank upside down. They managed to kick, the door got kicked open, and then Mickey was in an open door with the camera. He was able just to get out, fortunately. They swam up to the surface, and the rendezvous, the sailboat we've been filming, came around and threw him life rings and finally pulled him out of the water. But, fortunately,
the boat was